You know, when you are selected for competition in any film festival, it means that your work has been recognized by the programmers as something that is, you know, sort of worthy of a little bit more attention, you know, by a group of your peers. And as a filmmaker whose film, you know, was in competition a couple of years ago, I know it's nerve-wracking, and it's also just feels like such an honor because, you know, to be in competition is to really understand that there's something special about your film that the programmers wanted to elevate by putting it in competition. White Riot, which is the winner of the Grierson Award and the documentary feature documentary competition, you know, for us stood out as the film that really asks the question if the lessons of the past have actually been learned. You know, everyone says that if we don't learn the lessons of the past, we are doomed to repeat them. And the film really shows that all of the rhetoric about nationalism and sending people back to where they came from and, you know, the resurgence of white, you know, racist groups, this film is set in 1979. And if you took out that marker in the film, it could be 2019. So the important thing for us about White Riot is that it's an opportunity to reflect back at us what we're living through today, and also it gives us an example of how people responded to the same issues, you know, over 30 years ago. I think that everyone says, and I think it's true, that, you know, truth is stranger than fiction. But I think that, or real life is stranger than fiction. I think real life is also realer than fiction. I think that there's no way of capturing the complexity of, you know, what it feels like to be in a moment of an issue or of life or, you know, a political debate or whatever the subject of the film is. You know, when you follow someone through life with a camera, you get the thing about documentary is that you don't know what's going to happen. And in fiction film, you know what's going to happen. And so documentary is so special, and I think for me rises, you know, to a place of, you know, of equal standing with fiction film, because it presents, you know, a ride and a journey for the audience and for the filmmaker that you can't predict. Oh yeah, there are projects that you should look out for, but I'm certainly not going to tell you what they are. I've spent the last year or so, you know, sort of reorienting myself to real life after the Oscar nomination. You know, I was, you know, honored with an Emmy earlier this year, and you know, for me, I'm now settling back into being a documentary filmmaker, and I'm also moving into the fiction world as well. What I'm most proud of about Strong Island is that it presented a complex picture of an issue that, again, is still being dealt with today. And, you know, the question at the end of that film, how do we measure the distance of reasonable fear, can be applied to so many other things that are happening now, 2 years after the release of the film. So in some ways, I think that Strong Island will stand the test of time and really speaks to what I like to, you know, strive for as a filmmaker, which is complex, you know, material that calls for, you know, audience engagement and that lives outside of the theater as well.